evening, and thanks for joining us tonight. I'm Tracy Sable. It is a major break in the case of a young boy found dead in South Berwick. According to our sister station WCVB, citing police sources, the boy is 6-year-old Camden Pierce Hughes of Texas. And tonight, a woman is in custody. Now, take a look at the computer-generated image police first released over the weekend after the boy's body was found here in Maine. Now, take a look at a picture of Camden Pierce Hughes next to that image. After 5 days of a nationwide appeal, a woman was taken into custody in Massachusetts. And that is where we find News 8's Keith Baldy live tonight in Concord with the very latest. Keith?
Well, Tracy, we've been waiting for 4 days now for a break in this case, and now we finally have one. The Massachusetts State Police have taken a woman into custody. They did that this morning at about 10:30 at a rest stop along Route 495 here in Massachusetts. But just about an hour and a half ago, that woman was taken to an area hospital after the state police decided to take her for a medical evaluation. They are not saying whether it was for a physical or psychiatric evaluation. This woman was found in a blue pickup truck at this Massachusetts rest stop that we're about to see video of, and that is significant because it matches a description of a truck seen by a witness in South Berwick, where this little boy's body was found underneath a blanket on the side of Dennett Road on Saturday. And that is much of what the police have been going on now, a description of the truck and a computer-generated picture of the boy. According to our sister station WCVB, the woman taken into custody is Julianne McCreary, the mother of 6-year-old Camden Pierce Hughes, who was found at the scene. We have confirmed ourselves, News 8, that McCreary is a writer from Texas, and according to a biography, she has 2 sons, one in the military and one who is a child. Now, as far as how she was taken into custody today, the Massachusetts State Police explained that late this afternoon.
We received a call from a citizen who had seen prior coverage of this investigation and provided information that a vehicle of interest potentially was at the Chelmsford rest stop on the southbound side of the highway. We responded, several troopers there, and engaged that operator, female adult operator, lone occupant of the vehicle, and that's why we're here now.
Now, this certainly has been a day of developing news. Early this morning, we were in Alfred, Maine, at the state police barracks there, where they had a very, very short news conference where they told us that all information was now going to have to come out of the Maine Attorney General's office, a man named Bill Stokes. We talked to him. He said he couldn't confirm anything, and he did not have new information. Then we heard about this press conference here in Massachusetts. We drove down from Alfred here, got here, as they were telling us the small amount of information they were releasing, but they said all new information would come from the New Hampshire Attorney General's office. We also know that there are Maine State detectives here, as well as New Hampshire State Police detectives and members of the Attorney General's office. It's not clear exactly why the Attorney General's office from New Hampshire is now in charge of information about this case, but certainly if there was a crime that was to happen in New Hampshire or Maine, they would need to get the Attorney General's offices in those two states together to figure out who may eventually charge this woman. For now, we're live in Concord, Massachusetts. I'm Keith Baldy, News 8.